हेलो हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड आफ्टरनून। टुडेज टॉपिक इज ऑफशोर ड्रिलिंग ऑपरेशंस। सो हियर यू आर गोइंग टू सी अबाउट दी व्हाट आर द कंप्लीट ऑपरेशंस कैरिड आउट इन ऑफशोर। सी व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स लाइक ड्रिल बिट प्रोग्राम, केसिंग and nomenclature and briefing of your drilling risers, offshore drilling risers and BOP, stacking system in offshore, etc. So let's go to the presentation. So it's a offshore drilling operations. It's a short course which I have made for you, for all petroleum engineering students as well as the aspirants of offshore engineering and subsea technology. So let's describe the course outline. So the project management and offshore engineering. Then what are the equipments and systems utilized, offshore drilling program, and then your operational consideration in your offshore. So this is your brief course outline. So this is your conceptual layout of your offshore technology. So you can see the drill ship, you can see the platform, offshore platform and pipeline, how they are laying out in the offshore facilities. So there is a heli deck operation, then offshore process facilities also shown here. So you can go through it now. So there is also the glory holes in subsea drilling. So it's just like a excavational program in the subsea wells. So a glory hole in the offshore industry is the excavation. We are doing up to the sea floor to protect your wellhead equipments installed at the surface of the petroleum well as well as from the icebergs which are moving in the Arctic or packed ices. So this is a briefing of your glory hole in the offshore. So this is a glory hole dredging which they are doing. Then offshore production system. So you have the supporting vessels, production system, then subsurface binance. Then you have the crude oil transfer lines and also offshore loading system. So there are different types of towers are utilized, offshore towers, different type of platforms. So you have seen already in our past presentations, TLP, compliant towers, etc. Now next slide. So this is your drilling installations, how you are doing in your offshore system. So what are the general view of your offshore platform? So this is your FPSO, floating production and surface operating vessel. So let's go to the nomenclature of your offshore drilling operations. So you have the BHA, top drive, kick, site tracking, MWD, measurement while drilling, so mud logging, so wellhead, then SESSVs, KOP, kick off point, then BOP, fishing, then fishing tools also we will learn, top drive. So this is the nomenclature. So what are the types of drilling of systems utilized in your offshore, and this is your nomenclature, sidetracking, what types of well you are doing, horizontal or vertical well drilling, and measurement well drilling, well logging. Also, we had a one presentation, then well head, well control system, then CT, coil tubing, then XMAS tree, that is your well control, subsurface or surface, well head systems, then fishing, then we have the BHA, bottom hole assemblies, then top drive, etc. And also well logging. The next one, so you are part of our short course. We are going to see this drilling installation, well design, procurement, contracting, casing, cementing, and drilling fluids, etc. So drilling installation. So what we are going to see in the drilling installation. So environmental factors, weather, ice, water depth, station keeping, and also the power requirements like hoisting equipment, mud pumps, rotary systems, then well control equipments, then ROP rated, drilling depth, and regulatory requirements in the offshore, then geological prospectus like well depth, pressures, etc. So these are the drilling installation, including your solid controls also as shown here. Then environmental factors also included. So we have seen already, but now let's go to the next. So conceptual well design. So as a part of well design, so what for offshore well? So we are doing the geological objective of the well, evaluation objective, drilling hazards, formation pressures, what are the problem zone, then offset well data, and time estimation, so and the cost estimate of your project. So you are doing the well design also for your offshore well, formation pressures, so what are the hazards in your offshore drilling, then geometry of your well, etc. So all the well data, so this is your briefing of your well design, then you are carrying out the budget. Then next is your casing program. So what are the requirement? So we have the casing design, so same geological objectives, testing program, then overpressure zones, fracture pressure, then last circulation zone, then you are also detailed design, burst design, collapse, tensile, wear, and also the HTS, hydrogen sulfide corrosion, HTS. So this is the detailed design. You are seeing the burst design, collapse design, and tensile design, and wear, and HTS. So this is your casing program, and also calculating the grade, weight, connectors, and the setting according to your depth. Then cementing program. So what you are seeing? So you are seeing in the prior that you are doing the cementing. So how you are doing the offshore? So temperature, fracture pressures, last circulation zone. So regular regulatory requirements, zone isolations, well abutment, then well control, and detailed design. The cement tops, recipes, what are the slurry properties, so additives, then displacement, then equipments and procedures. So this is a detailed design of your cementing program, primary cementing, secondary cementing. So you are doing for your offshore well. So this is your program, casing cementing program. Then drilling fluids program. So drilling fluids, so well bore stability, formation protection, formation evaluation, then torque and dragging, equipment compatibility, last circulation zone, well control, and other recommendations. So whether it's a type of drilling fluids and decide physical and chemical properties and solid control requirements. This is your drilling fluids program and directional drilling program. So here, so we are doing the all the kickoff point, TVDs, KOP, types of curve, BUR, DUR, BHA, direction drilling assembly, MWD, etc. Then current targets, future targets and formations, faults and dip and torque and drag. So this is our drilling program. So types of bit, so everything you are selecting, all the drilling assemblies. So bit program. So we are now coming to the, especially the bit program. So lithology of hillocks, then compressive strength, abrasiveness of your bit, then stickness, offset bit records, then economics and recommendations. So what are the bit types you are choosing? So roller, cone bit, PDC, hydraulics, bit hydraulics, nozzles, etc. So this is your PDC roller cone bit. So we have already made one video on PDC bit. So you can go through it. Then equipment system. So again, we have to come back. Your circulating system, motion compensation equipments, drilling assembly, marine riser, icing system, and well control system. So there is a difference in onshore drilling product and offshore drilling. So in the drilling assembly, there will be a marine riser is being used. So this is your drilling mud circulation. You can see here, drilling mud circulation. Motion compensators. So you can see the motion compensators and heave compensators are attached along with your, you can see the traveling block. Then below that you have seen the heave compensators. Next one. So this is your marine riser. You can see the telescopic joint, flexible joint, then BOP, then wellhead. So marine riser offshore. So this is your hybrid riser tower by NNC. Next one. So this is your distributed buoyancy system in the offshore. Then drilling assembly. And now the new technology of Badger, new technology for your casing design. So it's a hands-free self-installing capacity connector, which saves your time and improves the safety. This is Badger, new technology for casing pipes. So the you are using the different types of connectors, casing connectors, conventional one. And other traditional methods are employed in the offshore industry. But so there must be in the offshore now industry, we are struggling to lower the operational cost and reduce the HSE, safety risk exposure in the offshore complex environments. So they are reevaluating. So that is why they have made this new type of technology, conventional casing. So this newly Badger connector, so it's a newly introduced connector, reduce the risk with the integration of unique hands-free anti-rotation device that allows your the connector to make up automatically in eliminating the need of the personnels in the red zone and preventing the damages from the dropped objects, missing components, damaged keys or injuries to the personnel. So this conventional connectors has been installed by one or two members in the red zone, but conventional connectors, but the Badger connect is a unique anti-rotation device. This can be pre-installed offline, allowing for reduced HSE, health, safety, environment by risk exposure, while also reducing your operational expenses and reducing your installation time. Then also in the drilling efficiency, so now RSS system. Now the industry has launched new rotary steerable systems which improve your drilling efficiency. Saber technology. So in this Saber, that is steer at bit intake rotary. So here this tool used for fire direction drilling, and the Shell company has proved it and tested positively, and the system is ready for your next stage field trials. So this in the Saber system uses an internally directed pressure differential system to steer from the drill bit face, which is to be provisioned at bit gear steering. And this mechanically simple design avoids the need for traditional pistons, pads, and which are susceptible to rapid wearing and also reliability issues, resulting in smoother and precise well bore, and also very easy to manage the directional control. This is Saber new RSS rotary steerable system. So also in the offshore drilling operations, so these are draw works and crown block, top drive, so drill floor. So an iron roughnecking, you can see here. Then mud pumps, pumps also. But now in the subsea operation, there is a new subsea pump technology has been introduced. So this is the most recent advances, one of the technology in the offshore, in order to design to increase the hydrocarbon recovery and reduce the capital expenses and operation expenses by improving your overall field designs. So one such technology is the transfer of well treatment chemical storage and pumping equipment from the host production facility to the seafloor and adjacent to the wells. And the advantage of this technology is that it allows the reduction of complex production umbilicals and assists in supporting the all electrical subsidiaries by moving the chemicals and electrical systems in the subsea. So this is their new electrical pump, subsea pumps technology. And this is your driller's cabin. And this is your well control BOP stack system, your load preventer stacking. This is your BOP control system with your nitrogen accumulators are arranged. And then drilling program. So what are the assumptions in your making in your drilling program in the offshore? So semi-submersible anchored 100 meter water depth. So first one, positioning your rig. Number two, run anchors. And number three, pre-tension mooring lines. And the survey the seafloor with ROVs, remotely operable vehicles. Then run the TGV, the spud the well, and the drill 36 inches, 914 mm hole to the up to 200 meters. And cement 30 inches conductor pipe and low pressure wellhead housing. So this is the second one. You can see here. Then drill 26 inches hole to 500 meters, run and cement 20 inches surface casing, pressure well and BOP stack and marine riser. Then drill 7 1/2 inches, that is 445 mm, hole to 1500 meters, run the wire line locks, run and cement 13 3 by 8 inches casing. This is your offshore drilling program. Then drill 12 1/4 inches hole to 3000 meters, core any hydrocarbon intervals, run oil and rocks, oil and loggings, and then run and cement 9 5 by 8 inches casing. Then drill 8 1/2 inches hole to 3500 meters, core any hydrocarbon intervals, run wire and logs, run and cement 7 inches liners 178 millimeter if the well is to be tested. Then semi-submersible and marine risers, then subsea BOP stack. So this is your subsea BOP and marine risers are shown here. So there is a difference between your onshore BOP stack and offshore BOP stack or subsea BOP stack. And operational consideration, so heavy weather conditions, marine forecasting, operational limits, icebergs, tea time, ice management. So all these things you have to consider in your offshore drilling operations. Then wind speed, waves, heave, pitch and roll. So this is your marine weather side forecast. You can see here for your offshore weather as shown. Valid date and time, wind direction, wind speed, wind waves, primary, secondary, then combined sea, etc. Height, maximum height, temperature, pressure, then freezing spray, etc. So this is your marine weather site forecast as shown. Then this is the wind speed recorded, 48 hours forecast for wind speeding. So they have shown the date, and so the only the red color shows the 100 mm flagging, then storm it's in blue color, then yellow color shows the maximum wind, then anemone is shown in the pink, then black also shown in the wind speed. So this is the 44 hour forecast wind speed system. Then same the heave, special heave predictors for different days, first 3 days or 2 days, and the linear progression for heaving forecast has been done at the standard operating draft, daytime versus heave meters in the offshore system. So this is your tea time, that is zone ice alert when there is a movement of your pack ice or icebergs, zone 3, then zone 2, time reduction, and width of zone. Zone 1 is the move up, so your location. So this is your zone ice alert in the offshore, that is tea time. Then ice management in your offshore and operations. Icebergs, So we have completed the today's offshore drilling operations. So we have completed today the offshore drilling operations. So you have learned something on your bit program, cementing program, then your casing programs, how we are doing the offshore platforms and what are the different types of casings, then nomenclature you learn. So in our next presentation, so we will see about the more on offshore platforms, design of your different types of offshore platforms. So you can visit my petroleum and chemical channel, subscribe my channel. Thank you.